What if we domesticated dinosaurs? It's little wonder that the dinosaurs were at the top of the food chain when they walked this planet, nor that they managed to stay there for millions of years. Many of them were apex predators, perfectly adapted to hunting and killing their prey. But would things have been different if humans had been around at the same time? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if we domesticated dinosaurs? Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more fascinating content. The dinosaurs may be extinct, but they had a long reign over the Earth, surviving for around 160 million years until they were wiped out 65 million years ago. To put that into perspective, modern humans date back only around 300,000 years, and even the absolute earliest types of bipedal beings are only thought to have emerged 4 million years ago. The dinosaurs have us soundly beat. Dinosaurs were as varied as any animals we can imagine. As the dominant species across land, sea, and air, some weighed over 80 tons, larger than most whales today, while others weighed as little as 8 pounds, the size of a large chicken. The Argentinosaurus, which unsurprisingly lived in what's now South America, was once one of the biggest creatures to ever grace our world, growing to be as much or more than 65 feet tall and 130 feet long. Meanwhile, something like the Stegosaurus is still held as one of the most bizarre animals of all time because of its strange skeletal structure and spiked back. If nothing else, the dinosaurs were definitely different. Unfortunately, or perhaps fortunately for us, most dinosaurs were killed off by the KT mass extinction, which wiped out over 75% of all plants and animals alive at the time. We say most because although all of the land-dwelling types died, not all of their flying counterparts did, and some actually evolved into the birds we know today. The exact cause of the extinction remains a relative mystery, although scientists have two popular theories for how it happened. The most famous is the impact theory that the dinosaurs were wiped out by a meteorite that struck down where the Chicxulub crater is today. The other, volcanic theory, says that multiple massive eruptions were the cause of the dinosaurs' demise. Whatever the case, their disappearance rewrote the food chain and paved the way for the rise of the mammals. Humans and dinosaurs never coexisted, despite what the Flintstones implies. But what if we did? Humanity would certainly strive to take control over the creatures that most threatened them. Though they were excellent predators, dinosaurs weren't usually smarter than most animals alive today, with most boasting notoriously small brains. In fact, in the case of the ever-interesting Stegosaurus, its brain was so small that scientists once thought it might have had a second brain in its butt. Using the encephalization quotient to measure species intelligence, and keeping in mind that humans have a highest on Earth EQ of 7, some dinosaurs would have only clocked in at 0.1. So considering the types of beasts that humans have bested in the past, it's not too far a stretch to suggest that we could outsmart and eventually domesticate the dinosaurs. Having achieved that, we'd soon find that certain dinosaurs excel in certain areas, with one of the first questions we'd sadly but inevitably ask ourselves being, how can we weaponize them? Whether in this alternate reality we existed as we do now, or as though in tribes from the start of human history, the destructive potential of dinosaurs would offer an unparalleled option for defense and means of attack. If it were possible to tame a T-Rex, say, then it would be frontline fodder in most wars. In fact, with the likes of the Triceratops and the tank-bodied Ankylosaurs under our control, we may never have developed regular tanks at all, because we'd never have needed to. Fortunately, humanity does also have a lighter side that isn't just geared towards war. So what else would domesticated dinosaurs offer? The Carnotaurus is thought to have been especially fast and muscular with a strong tail for balance and speed, so it's likely that we'd train them for transportation much as we've done with horses. Then there's the wolf-sized Guanlong, which we might have bred as a hunting companion, or the herbivorous Labrador-sized Psittacosaurus, a prime candidate as a household pet. In general, the types of dinosaurs available as pets would be even more varied than pet options today, with herbivores understandably being preferred inside the home. As they were really only about the size of turkeys, even domesticated velociraptors would probably be treated as a pest, or a meal. But they'd also be one of many breeds that dominant humans could wind up betting on. As with dog and horse racing, we'd set up whole industries based on which dinosaur can run fastest. A knock-on effect of that would see the hunting of dinosaurs also transform into big business, with trainers wanting the fastest, fittest, and most potentially lucrative dinosaurs to run for them. Along with the Velociraptor, the Cynornithoides would be another prime target, given its reputation as quite the roadrunner. If not for racing, then dinosaur hunts would aim to capture beasts of burden, to work on farmlands, across fields, or simply to carry supplies on long journeys. And failing that, there'd no doubt be a demand for a dinosaur zoo, so the hunts would also set out to stock the enclosures at real-life Jurassic parks. For various reasons, the capture and trade of tameable dinosaurs would be a major, although quite regrettable, trend. What about the rest of the dinosaurs? The ones that can't be weaponized, house-trained, or put to work? They'd meet different fates. Just as we've done with a large number of today's animals, non-essential dinosaurs might be driven to a different extinction through human-led deforestation and habitat destruction, while others may well find themselves domesticated, but only to be bred as food. Given that in this world, humans will have universally mastered the dinosaurs, it'd take just a few generations before the creatures were selectively bred for all of these purposes. Humans would locate the most desirable traits in any given type, like speed, strength, weight, temperament, or appearance, and make sure those qualities are passed on and, if possible, enhanced. Before long, we'd be rearing super dinosaurs for specific tasks, but they'd now be totally different to what we currently imagine dinosaurs to be. Over thousands of years, total domestication could even see the scarier dinosaurs sharing our homes as pets, eating store-bought dinosaur food. Their appearance may well have changed, and the predatory instinct might even have been bred out of them, or at least significantly lessened. With so many massive animals affecting our lives, we may never have needed as many machines. But it's an alternate timeline where the dinosaurs experience a totally different lifestyle, one in which they're hunted, they serve, and they grow to be as dependent on us as we would be on them. It isn't exactly a happier history, but that's what would happen if humans domesticated dinosaurs. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.